So how many of us remember the first time we were shot? I don't mean by a gun, I mean by that. Our first shot, right? Our very first vaccine. And I remember being at the doctor's office as a child and going in and being vaccinated and just thinking it was the worst thing in the world ever because it hurt so much. And then I learned what vaccines are, and it was really helpful for me. So let's talk about that together. So I have two images here, and let's get rid of that needle because it's pretty scary. So I have one of the influenza vaccine labeled flu, and one of the pneumococcal vaccine labeled pneumo. Now, if we're talking about the flu vaccine, we know that the flu vaccine is going to protect us against the influenza virus. Oops, there's my U, influenza virus. And we know that getting the flu is a pretty crummy thing. Now we know that the flu vaccine can protect us against 3 or 4 different serotypes. So what does that mean? So the flu vaccine comes in a trivalent, let me change my color here, or a quadrivalent. And what does that mean? So if you had a trivalent vaccine, it's going to protect you against 3 different serotypes of the flu. And serotypes really mean strains, right? So different types. Whereas a quadrivalent can protect you against 4 different strains or serotypes of the flu. And that's really important with this type of vaccine and this type of virus, because we know that the flu vaccine changes on a yearly basis. And it's important that we're able to keep up with it and protect the individual against the most appropriate strain. And so how does that work? When I say the influenza virus changes, it really does. So let's say that 1 year, and we'll say this was 2012, that the flu virus looked like this. And then let's say that the next year, the flu virus looked like this. And then let's say that in another year, it looked like this. So you see that it changes a little bit every single year. And that's why it's important that research and data are able to look at all these changes and to figure out what the most likely virus is going to be this year to protect us against it. Now, just like we have a flu vaccine that protects us against 3 serotypes or 4, our pneumococcal vaccine is pretty similar in that. We have vaccines that can protect us from anywhere from 7 to 23 different strains. And that's pretty important too. Now, if you notice in the name, the pneumococcal looks like pneumonia, and it should, because pneumococcal diseases actually cause things like pneumonia and ear infections and meningitis, all the things that we don't want to get. It protects us against the pneumococci bacteria. So I'm going to go ahead and write pneumococcal so we know what we're dealing with. Now, what do we have to know about these vaccines? These are inactivated vaccines. So what that means is that it's essentially the killed virus. So if we come over here, I'm going to draw a picture, and let's say that this is the influenza virus. So I'm going to just make it round like this, and then I'm going to put some green squiggly shell on the outside. Now I want to draw it like this so you can see something. So if I said that this flu vaccine is inactivated, that means that it's killed. So what we do is we actually destroy the virus, so destroy the pathogen, destroying what causes the infection, what causes all those bad symptoms. But I'm going to leave that protein shell intact. And I'm going to leave it intact in the vaccine for a reason. I want the body to recognize this as a foreign invader and build up a defense to it. So how does that work? Let's scroll down here. And I'm just going to draw a blood vessel. Now remember that syringe that we saw earlier, that scary syringe? Let's say that scary syringe had this flu vaccine in it. So it's gonna have this protein shell. So I'm going to draw this protein shell here in the body. Now what's gonna happen? It's been introduced into me through that scary needle, right? Now my white blood cells are gonna show up to the scene. And we know my white blood cells, these are my security guards, right? This is my defense system. They're going to protect me against anything that's coming to hurt me. In this case, my white blood cells recognize that this guy right here doesn't belong. And so what are they going to do? They're going to attack. So my white blood cells are going to reach out and they're going to beat up, or they're going to attack this foreign invader. Now, because this is an inactivated vaccine, that it's not really the flu virus, it's just the protein shell, it's not enough to make me sick. It is enough that my body recognizes it shouldn't be there, and it's going to beat it up, like we said, right? It's going to attack it, going to destroy it, and it's going to remember and put in there its imaginary pocket. It's going to put in a picture of this flu virus. That way it's going to remember, if this virus ever shows up again, I know how to beat you. Now, because it's still part of the virus, because it still has a protein shell, there's a small chance that it could manifest in us some very, very mild symptoms of the illness, but it's not enough to make us sick. Now, who benefits from vaccines? Really anybody, but especially individuals that have lung disease. So let's just draw our lungs here. So especially someone that has got chronic lung disease, like chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, somebody that has emphysema. And the reason why they benefit from these vaccines is because they're more likely to get the disease and they're less likely to be able to fight it off on their own. And then finally, I'll end with this last thing. We have something called a vaccine information statement, and sometimes you might see it called VIS. So vaccine information statement, and this is really a piece of paper that we give to our patients. And you see that I just am writing flu and pneumo on here. And what it is a sheet that has information about the vaccine so that the patients are aware of everything about it, what's in it, how it's made, what it's used for, and that way they're clear on the vaccine that they're receiving.